VectorNator's toolbar is positioned on the left-hand side of the interface. This is where you can access all of the app's built-in tools, which allow you to select objects, draw and create shapes, add text, and much more. This illustration was made in VectorNator, and we're going to use it to demonstrate all of these capabilities. Depending on the tool that you've selected, the inspector menu will change accordingly. So, for example, if you select the text tool, you will see that the text panel appears here, at the top of the inspector, which will help you edit your text. Let's start with the first tool in the toolbar, which is the selection tool. This is used, of course, to select an object on your canvas. But as you see here, we have multiple modes in which the selection tool can be utilized. Multi-select allows you to select multiple objects at once. Duplicate, when activated, will allow you to select an object, and as you're dragging it on your canvas, it will automatically duplicate. Or you can edit an object in various ways by selecting it and then tapping on Rotate, or tapping on Scale, which is here. This is what it looks like. And as you can see, the aspect ratio is preserved as the object is scaled up or down in size. The second tool on the list is the Node tool. With the Node tool, you can select and edit all the nodes in your object. So if I select these objects here, you can notice how it selects and highlights all the existing anchor points in these shapes. The Scissor tool, which is up next, helps you to cut one path into multiple segments by simply tapping along the path. The Pen tool. As many of you might know, this tool is very important in vector design. It allows you to create smooth, linear, or curved vector paths, like so. But we have separate videos explaining how all these tools work individually, if you want to learn more. The Pencil, on the other hand, works like a freehand tool. For example, I can draw a curved vector line in a matter of seconds. The smoothness of the pencil can be controlled in this slider right here. So I will increase the smoothness and draw another curved line. You can notice that they look different based on the smoothness that I selected. With the brush tool, you can easily create vector brush paths. Remember, everything you create in VectorNator is a vector. And in the style tab on the right-hand side, you can change the properties of the brush you need to use. Or you can select one from the drop-down menu of our preset brush pane, which is right here. Moving on to the text tool, which you can use to create any text you want. In the quick actions menu right here, you can change the text size or the text box. But these properties and more are also available in the inspector. So you can keep changing the size of your text, the style, and so on. Continuing our way down, we have the Shape tool, which gives you access to this list of pre-made shapes by tapping on the three dots button at the top of the slider, like the rectangle or the polygon, which, when selected, allows you to change the number of sides of your polygon. You can also draw beautiful stars super easily. You can create ovals. And for a perfect circle, just tap and hold with one finger to lock in the aspect ratio. Of course, you can create simple lines here as well, like so. Or spirals. By using the slider that appears on the right-hand side of the menu, you can draw tighter or looser spirals, based on what you're looking to create. This one kind of looks like the golden spiral, doesn't it? Now, moving on, we have the eraser, which works exactly like you would think. It erases part of an object. The hand tool helps you to pan the canvas. Lastly, with the zoom tool, you can zoom into the canvas by tapping it. And that is it for the inspector menu. These are all the tools you need to start creating.